Please give me a very warm welcome to Douglas Smith.
Yes, I'm feeling ready for TED. I mean, I'm not really actually ready right now, but I know I will be. In, what is it? The first rehearsal in Vancouver is in 7 days, so I'll be ready in 7 days.
Hi, kitten.
Hi. This is a very special moment because it's TED, so it's a big deal. I feel like, for me, I've been doing the work, and so I'm not surprised that I'm going to be on the main stage of TED at all, because I believe that good work begets good work and great opportunities. So I know how hard I've been working, you know, for the last 17 years since I've become Bevy Smith, you know, morphing from Beverly Smith fashion advertising executive to morphing into Bevy Smith public persona, you know. And so, yeah, I really feel very like, okay, I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be. I'm on my way to TED Talk heading to Canada. And I just found out today that I'm speaking at the same time as Bill Gates. I mean, not at the same time, but in the same place. Thank you. Wow, the journey of preparing for it was, well, the first part of the journey is, one, you've got to write the damn thing. And then you've got to rewrite the damn thing. And then you've got to write the damn thing again. And then you've got to rewrite it some more. And so I worked with this amazing friend of mine who has looked at and edited every single thing I've ever written, Stan Williams.
It is true that I've read pretty much everything she's written, and I've read this several times, and every time I've heard it, it gets even better.
And you know, I think maybe it took 4 or 5 tries. Bobby, how many tries did it take? Come over here, Bobby, so they can see you. Bobby is my coach at TED.
Every rehearsal was just, I just felt passionate to help her figure, I guess, like, concretize what it was she wanted to say, you know, the message. And Bevy's such a great speaker. She's hilarious as hell. And so it never felt like work. It just felt like, honestly, having dinner or like chatting with a friend or grabbing drinks or being with your like really amazing auntie.
You have amazing, amazing energy.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, amazing.
The speakers, huh?
This is it. This is real now.
The whole process, one, of working with TED in general has been really stellar.
Super excited. I just came out with rehearsal. I'm not nervous, but I did love. So my thing is, obviously, we always learn lessons and whatever it is that we're doing, and everything is as it should be. And maybe that's why I'm not nervous, because everything is as it should be. So when that's the case, if you really believe that, then what are you nervous about?
Tomorrow, on April 12th, which is some kind of like rare cosmic day, April 12th, 2022, I'm gonna be taking the main stage at TED. And when I tell you I'm taking that main stage at TED, like ferociously, confidently, and I'm doing it for every Black girl that has ever been othered. And I'm doing it for women in general. But this one goes out with the special chef's kiss to every Black girl who's ever been othered. Because I'm going to show them, because I'm going to show out. And I'm going to deliver this talk with not one stitch of imposter syndrome. I know exactly why I'm here. I know I deserve to be here. And so I can't wait to do it. And I'm really very excited for the world to see a Black woman of my ilk on so many different levels deliver such a powerful word. That's what we're doing today. We're going with the flow. We've done the work. We are prepared. When we get on that stage, we are going to feel grounded. We're going to feel connected. And that's all we're looking for, authentic connections in that room, in that theater. And then we're going to make it do what it do. And we'll see what it is. And we don't have any attachment to the outcome.
I'm pleased because I have beautiful children, beautiful friends, and I have God.
We're just going to go forth, always do our best, knowing that our best is always subject to change, but we feel good today. And I think that my best might be my absolute best today. That's what I'm going forth with, this, with an attitude of excellence and gratitude.
Coming to the stage, Bevy Smith, Lou Brown Bevy, Big Bev from Uptown, all the things. She's all showing up. So we're at TED 2022. The theme is New Era. I'm in session 6. It's the same session as Bill Gates and neuroscientists and people with huge long titles that do jobs that I can't even fathom. And then here I am, and they labeled me a pop culture queen, so this should be exciting. But here's the thing to remember. I'm supposed to be here. To compare is to despair. So I am not showing up with imposter syndrome or insecure about, oh my God, am I enough? I know that I'm enough. So we gonna make it do what it do. And we gonna show up and show out, and we're gonna represent for Harlem, because that's what we always do.
Don't get up. I'm here to see you.
Oh my God. All
right.
Thank you.
See you.
The takeaway for me when after I do the TED Talk is I want for my mantra, it gets greater later, I want it to permeate society. So many people don't know that, you know, while youth is amazing, but you're only young for a very short period of time. You're a kid from like when you're born to maybe 30 years old. And so if I can get people to stop feeling nervous or bad or like time is passing by because they turn 30 or 40 or 50 or 60 or even 70 or 80, that's what I would like for people to do, to realize that it really does get greater later. And again, it's not just about the age, it's about the attitude, it's about the spirit.
It's greater later.
I love you too, little Lolly.
And I'm very proud of her. Very proud. Dad would be proud of you too.